Hey, welcome to episode 72 of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble. Today is Saturday, February 24th, 2007, and even though I've about had it with Britney Spears trying to sneak in here and cut off all of Yivvits' hair, I'm Mr. Bubble.
And I'm Yivvits, and I don't want my hair cut off.
I know, that chick, she wants to cut the hair off. What's her thing?
She misses.
What's so important? What's she carrying?
She looks terrible like that, you know?
Oh, I agree.
Yeah, Obi-Wan agrees.
Obi-Wan. You know, he's a Jedi. He's supposed to be, you know, chased and all that stuff. And yeah. He's like, that chick looks horrible.
She's terrible.
Right, that'd be a Mace Windu.
He's right.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, my God. Dear.
Okay. We are friends. This is on the other side. This is Yivvits, a Wookiee, an actual Wookiee.
Uh-huh.
He's a Wookiee. I'm a Solistan. And everybody knows what a Solistan is, but I have to explain Wookiee every time.
Nobody knows what a Solistan is.
Right. I'm so sick of that.
I sloppy chops.
I should have picked a character.
Sloppy chop.
Wookiees are pretty slobbery, too, I've heard.
Oh, anyway. Come on. We only drool when we're content.
Oh.
Like a cat.
Cute. Oh, kitty drool. We are friends. Just so you know, you're listening.
Yeah, just so you know, because you might be concerned.
We're friends. Yeah, right.
You might be concerned.
In real life. And we're in the same room here. That's a big difference with our podcast.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, we play, but the focus is Star Wars Galaxies. We play Star Wars Galaxies.
Mm-hmm.
We talk about the game.
We sometimes play Star Wars Galaxies.
Yeah. Sometimes we play Super Pong.
And we've done that bit 100 times.
Beep.
I'm not going to bim.
Give me a boop.
Boop.
There you go. Beep. Boop. There you go. I win. All right. So we talk about Star Wars Galaxies because it has a lot of news, like major news.
Yeah.
And what we do in the game. And if not that, if sometimes there are weeks we just don't play. We just talk about Star Wars.
We talk about Star Wars. Plenty of Star Wars. You got to say that it's the key. That's the key word. Plenty of Star Wars.
And of course, plenty of Star Wars.
Yeah. See?
Right.
There you go.
Now, and then we have a disclaimer that we do so we can talk about anything else.
Oh, I really have to do that still?
Yeah.
Ah, crap. Okay. Right. We have nothing to do with Luke. What?
Return it.
I'm just disclaimer.
Just return the ball to me and then I'll...
Boop.
Thank you. I win.
We have nothing to do with Luke. Stop. Stop. Nothing to do with Lucasfilms, LucasArts, or Sony Online Entertainment. All parodies and impersonations and sound effects and music and all that other stuff are for comedic effect only.
Right.
Yeah. So there you go.
Well, that's good.
So we've got nothing to do with them, so don't sue us.
Because that's an important thing.
We don't make any money on this either, so we don't sue us for that either.
Right. And we will give you your money back if you don't like this show. Right.
Yeah, because, there is no money to give back. We'll pay you if you didn't like the show. Yeah. How about that?
It used to be we'd pay people to listen. Yeah.
We still do that.
Yeah,
are you kidding?
That's true. Just my parents, yeah. Like, come on, Mom, listen.
She's like, where's my 20?
Right.
Yeah.
But, no, that's very important, Yivvits, because we're not on the dole. I mean, we are not Sony. I mean, we'll talk into this in a second, but we're just chumps that play the game. And we started talking about it a long time ago.
Yeah, that's
right. And we're still talking about it.
Wait, I'm not a chump. You're a chump.
Yeah. Oh, okay, I'm a schmuck.
Wookie.
Who's a schmuck and who's a chump? Which one are you?
I don't want to be either.
Well, who are you?
I want to be a Wookiee.
Okay, Wookiee.
I'm a Wookiee.
I'm a chump. I'm a
yeah,
schmuck.
All right. Sloppy chump.
Sloppy chump. But anyway, we do actually play the game. We pay to play all that stuff because it is one of those games you have to pay $15 for.
It's like playing the Fae, but playing the Star Wars.
Yeah, you can't be fairies in this game.
No.
Yeah.
No.
And there are no dragons.
You can be Solus. Solus are a lot like fairies, but.
But there are no little tree elves in this game.
No, there's no spell. Oh, there are spells. That's true.
There's no dragons.
Like, all the healing is spells.
Yeah. What else are there not?
It kind of is fantasy then.
There's like no buffing. Wait a minute. Okay.
There's no gnomes. Oh, there's Jawas.
Oh, yeah.
There's Bothans. They're
horses?
About the same size.
Those are horses.
No, there's mounts.
Yeah, but that's Varactyls. Those are cool. Oh, yeah, right. Let me hear your Varactyl. Can you do that?
I can't do it. I can't do it in the
If
fly,
you ever did, slip in it, if you can.
It takes a lot of voice training before the show.
That's true.
For me
You're like
to do
Caruso
that.
In the background, like, la, 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 la.
Right. Yeah.
Like, Mr. Caruso, 5 minutes!
Except it sounds like a jungle.
Yeah, right, except there's this Varactyl sound effect coming out of there. You're like,
I almost choked on that doing that once, too.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
I remember, I have that. That's on YouTube right now.
Pretty bad. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
30-year-old male choking trials to do a Varactyl sound effect.
Right.
10 million views.
Yay.
Plugs. Do you want to do plugs?
You can get more of our show at www.swgpodcast.com. And that's where you can download the crazy all the episodes and you can click on the archives to get a list. I think we got back to, maybe
20-something
there.
Yeah.
We still got to repost the old ones. We keep saying we're going to do it.
We say a lot of things.
We say a lot of things. We don't do a lot of things. Yeah. We do pretty much nothing. And you can subscribe to it there with like a, you know, like a program like iTunes or some other program.
Right.
Yeah, you don't have to like, people keep asking me, is there a new episode? Is there a new episode? If you subscribe to it with an RSS feeder, I mean, look, Firefox has RSS feed readers, right?
Oh, I think so.
Yeah. IE7 has them.
Okay.
Or you can get a podcast program that does it.
Okay.
Like iTunes or something.
Oh, so just you? No, I'm not just humoring here. I mean, I really didn't know that. So through the two most common browsers, you can just subscribe to our show.
Well,
so,
I don't know if you had to get a plugin. Look, I admit it. I'm not a Firefox user.
No, no, I'm just
don't
saying
work
IE7
at work. But IE7 has RSS feeds built into it.
Meaning what with our show?
So meaning like they can subscribe to the feed.
Yeah.
And then they'll have a little tab with their feeds that they can go look at and see if there's new stuff. It gets aggregated into one feed.
Oh, aggregated.
So they can
you
see
that when you're drinking your tea? I shall go aggregate something.
Yeah, I do. Okay. Right.
Sure. Pardon me, I'm off to play the grand piano.
Uh-huh, yeah. That's great. Nice. So yeah, you can do that, or you can go to. You can get it. Another. You got me all messed up now, Mr. Bubble. You're terrible. Sloppy chops. So yeah, there you go. You can go there and get more of the show. And if you have problems downloading that stuff, search for like RSS feeds because RSS feeds are awesome.
You are a big fan of those. I'm
an RSS feed
totally
maniac. That's why you got. If you want to keep up on blogs, and podcasts. Yeah. And the Star Wars Galaxy's official forms. Oh, no, you can't because they don't have that feature anymore.
I know.
But I think they want to have it back. Yeah. So we'll keep that in mind. I'll just keep poking Virago.
That is handy because when we... What? Don't poke him on his nose.
No, I was just thinking about his nose.
Poor guy.
Poor guy.
I know.
I mean, that's a lot of times to break your nose.
Eight times. If you listened to last week,
eight times.
Mentioned he's an actual developer of Star Wars.
What do you mean, though? He's a developer. Like, he shouldn't break his nose because he's a developer.
No, it's just there's some notoriety to it because that's who he is. It's not like just some schmuck.
Let me get these plugs done. I don't know where I'm going with this. You can also go to our forums and our discussion site at www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com.
Yep, or call us. Simple. 651.
Yeah, it's voicemail.
Yeah, 651-314-4357. And we'll get to it later in the show, but you can leave a question or a comment and maybe we'll play it on the air.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Maybe not.
Now,
maybe we'll
if
mock
they call
you and
right
not play
now,
on the air.
For the next limited 15-minute time, they can call and be on the air right now. I'm just kidding. Don't
now,
do that.
Let me ask the guy in the booth. Can we get flex pay on this one? Is that possible? I'm hearing we can do flex pay on this one.
We
folks.
Can do it.
We can do flex pay. So it's two easy payments. Yeah, I love that. I love it when it's like a big deal if they can get flex pay or not.
You're flex pay.
Yeah.
That's how you pay all your bills.
Yeah, flex
pay. Yeah, I've got this $14 pizza check for Pizza Hut. Can I get that flex pay?
Folks, this baseball card will go up in value.
Yeah. All right.
Now, here's the thing. We normally, now I would say, hey, what are you doing, Yivvits? Or you'd say, what are you doing, Mr. Bubble? We just want to do a little preamble to that.
Why?
Well, here's why. And you know why, dude.
No, I don't.
Because, starting, was it last week? When was it? Tuesday, Wednesday?
Something like that.
Something like that. We started appearing on the load screen, or the launch pad. Yeah.
It is now known as the launch pad.
The launch pad. When you play Star Wars Galaxies, made by Sony.
Any of the SOE games, they all have a launch pad.
Oh, so we're on other
ones? No. But they have, they all have a launch pad.
But we're only on the Star Wars Galaxy.
Well, yeah,
right?
Of course.
We're not on the Caribbean
that would
Pirates
make no sense.
Card
that would make
game.
No sense.
So we are on this launch pad, which is really nice. It really increased our listenership.
That was really nice of them.
Yeah, that was nice.
That kind of came out of the summit that we went to. There was a discussion about how can they help other community people like blogs and podcasts.
They published the title right there and everything, episode 71.
Yeah, how can they help us get more people to our stuff?
Yeah.
So if you noticed, I don't know if you play EQ2 out there, but if you do, you might notice that the EQ2 Daily podcast was linked on their launch pad.
That's so cool.
Just like them, we're special too. Okay, we're not special.
Thing is we're right on there. More people are listening.
And we appreciate it.
We actually do play the game, and I've been getting a lot more questions just out of the blue, about like
are you single?
Where do I meet a man like you? No.
and it's from a man's voice.
And I say, Steve, No, that's like when I'm walking in the grocery store.
It is only natural.
Yeah. Okay, Palpatine.
So
Obi-Wan,
powerful and
Obi-Wan,
so wise.
Do you get comments like that about you?
No.
Okay. I guess it's just me.
No, he doesn't.
Yeah, right.
I don't trust him.
I don't
trust him either.
Beard. Maze. I don't trust men with beards.
No, you're right. Terrible.
Exactly.
Wait.
Hey.
That's because I'm a Wookiee.
Yeah, right. You have a beard all over. You're like bearded everything. Yeah. You know, like one big beard. One walking beard. I'll tell you.
Okay, that was bad. All right, so what are we trying to get to with that?
Well, that's on there. Well, just because like we do play the game, and I've been hit up with some questions. I just want to do just a quick little overview of what we're because this might be the last time they're ever going to listen to us because they're going to say, "What's this crap?"
And they're going to go, "Wait, I don't care about this."
Right.
There was some contention as to whether or not we'd do this.
Right. So, you have every right to trim it out. So
yeah. Well, no, I don't.
Here we go.
Throw a little fit.
This is.
All right. Okay. Please go ahead. Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Rubble.
Just so you know, it's a podcast. You're listening to it now, which is great. You've made a first step.
You made a first step into a much bigger world.
Right. Well, with the blast shield down. Right.
He's right.
We talk about Star Wars, and we said that already. But if you can't tell already, we don't take it too seriously. We have absolutely nothing to do with Sony. People think since we got on the mainstream, I've been getting mad. It's like, we have nothing to do with it.
We can't get paid for this.
There'd
be like a million.
Oh my god! Can you imagine
licensing issues?
Yeah, every
just because I just played that sound effect.
Yeah, do it.
Oh, I agree.
Yeah. See, I mean, how funny it is. It'd be so illegal to do that if we're getting money. Yeah, they're just labors of love. I tell you.
Ah, yes.
Right. But
you can go to the Lake Country where no one will know.
It's a love labor.
Yeah, Natalie Portman. Hey,
I know the perfect spot.
Yeah, you do. You gotta know your spot.
All
right.
Oh.
It's we don't take it too seriously. We have some fun.
We have fun with it. But we keep it honest. I mean,
yeah, right.
If you listen to some of the last 70 of these?
Yeah.
70 episodes, you'll know that there's been lots of times where we're very critical.
Well, 70 times, I would say.
But yeah, exactly. No, there was a couple good times.
Oh, right. Like that, episode. But then, so there were 68 times.
That's because it was Christmas. But,
right.
No, but, you know, we try to be fair, but it also is about issues to us, like our own personal issues.
Yeah.
If you agree with that, take many podcasts.
No, that'd be, right.
I don't know.
Episode 300 of Yivvits has mental problems. Yeah.
Great.
Welcome to episode
300. No, but I mean, you know. If we have an issue and you agree with it, that's great. But not everybody's going to agree with what we say.
Right.
And just keep in mind that they're not taking us as like, what do you give it to Mr. Bubble think?
Yeah.
That's far from it.
No, but I like how we do that too. Sometimes will there be a topic that drives us nuts and we'll keep hammering and talking about it like it's bugging everybody. Like the one I'm going to mention later in my personal bit.
But the thing is, we do know that there are people that does bug. So I think the times that I talk about that stuff, I try to keep it things that I know other people have issues with.
Right.
Not maybe everybody or the majority or anything like that, but people have issues with it.
If it saves one life, it's worth it.
If it saves one NPC, it's worth it.
So that's kind of what we are. We've been doing this, as Yivvits said, about 70 or 71 episodes. It went back to, I think,
2005.
Oh
dear.
Yeah. Right. And just when the podcast started taking off,
we started worldwide. It because of like the
what
we've gone through this before.
I know, but it's always somebody's first time.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. So we started this after the CU. It was after the CU.
Barely. You're right. You're absolutely right.
A couple months.
That was in April, wasn't it?
Because we didn't. Yeah. There's nothing left. I mean, we were pissed off, and of course we'd be more pissed off later. But
yeah.
The history books will show that.
Right. It was always a dwindling. It was funny. Like, we kept thinking we're at the bottom, but then more people kept leaving, and, you know, unbelievable.
But it's gotten better.
Yeah. And we started just when iTunes came out with podcasts built in, that's kind of when it's like, oh, this is going to be big. So I heard Rush Limbaugh was doing podcasts.
Yeah, then you had to do it.
Like, if that guy could do it.
If Rush can do it, Mr. Bubble can do it.
If his crowd could figure out podcasts, certainly the Star Wars Galaxy's crowd could figure them out.
Oh, I agree.
Yes, Obi-Wan. Yes.
He's right.
Yes. Thank you. Right.
So that's us.
That was that. We do a lot of voices on the show. Yeah, that's right. Those are fun.
Ah, yes.
Like John Smedley, president of Sony Online Entertainment.
Hey, hi, guys.
Hey, John Smedley.
Hi. How are you guys liking Chapter 5?
Yum. It's like a big, hearty Thanksgiving dinner.
Oh, it's so fun.
I'm so full after Chapter 5.
I've been reverse engineering all night.
Oh, yeah.
Helios, come over here.
What?
I know you don't work on this project anymore, but
I'm playing my Nintendo Wii. I'm shaking the control. I'm playing tennis.
That's good.
I'm bowling now. I'm shaking the control.
Okay.
All right.
Have fun.
There you go. That's why we're free. That's why people aren't paying for this crap. But those are actual developers.
And just for the record, Helios wasn't fired or anything. He's working on another project, I believe.
But maybe not.
I mean...
Was he assassinated?
People move on to other... That's the thing. Every time something happens in the dev team now for Star Wars Galaxies... I know this is kind of not on the topic, but every time something happens, people assume it's because of the NGE.
Oh, right. Yeah.
It's like, you know, maybe it's just that they're on a different project.
Yeah, maybe the guy got assumed to make an installation program for some thing. You know what I mean?
I mean, I don't know anything, but I'm just going to guess here that, you know, it's...
Simpler of two answers is the
exactly.
right solution.
Exactly. Right. Does it make more sense that he was the mastermind behind everything and got fired for it or something else?
Right.
Anything else? Yeah. I don't know. But
In Star Wars Galaxies, we're on the Valsin server.
Yeah, it's Valsin.
And not because it's the best server at the time. It's actually, you picked it. Why'd you pick it when you said
I don't know. I was a newbie, so I just picked what it said.
It looked like a cool name.
It was saying recommend this galaxy.
Oh, there
so,
you go.
Fates would have it that would be the one.
And then when you started, I believe, in July of 04.
Yep. Okay. Yep.
I started in October of 04, a little bit after you. You kept saying, oh, you got to do it.
Yeah.
My Wookiee, he's a... I remember we'd go to movies back then once in a while with our group, and I remember... We got in the car once.
From the group home.
Right. The group. Yeah. We go see Benny Goodman concerts. And then, No. But I remember we picked him once and, how are you doing, Yivvits? And you're like, oh, my tune, he's grinding. And I remember neither of us who were in the car were like, what? What are you doing?
Well, but that's an
MMO grinding Pikeman. He's grinding Pikeman. And you were so happy. I'm like, okay.
He's grinding Pikeman.
Yivvits is a master Pikeman. You're like, yay.
No, that wasn't Yivvits, though.
Oh, who?
Okay. That was Stivvy.
Stivvy was a master Pikeman, yay.
Yeah, he was master Pikeman Ranger.
Oh, yeah. Potent combo.
But anyway, you
picked Valsin, and because you were on there and we were friends in the same town, I picked Valsin.
It's unfortunate, but that's the way it was.
I know. And when we do live in the same town, we're like literally three blocks from each other.
It's crazy.
Yeah,
I've been thinking of moving.
I know.
Moving, at least another block.
Yeah. One block closer to Taco John.
I don't trust him.
Yeah.
No, that's why I'm moving.
Okay. So we're both on Valsin, and people have asked me that. Not because... whatever, blah, blah, Valsin. Just that's, we had to pick a spot.
We just picked Valsin.
So we do tend to mention Valsin a lot and people on Valsin a lot because that's where we play.
That's where we play with our Wii. So, yeah.
With our Wii.
Wii.
So now that leads me into, how are you, Yivvits?
Oh, gosh, now it's me.
Yes, it's all you. Spotlight on you. What's up?
Not much. Okay. Just been hanging out.
There are a lot of people who've never listened before.
Oh, I'm not going to do that every episode thing now.
No, this is the first time.
Well, yeah, but how is that any different? I mean,
okay, fine.
I'm not going to make it different, because if I make it different, it's going to sound not right.
Okay.
It won't be normal.
That's what I like about Wookiees.
It won't be normal.
So straightforward.
Yeah.
Oh, I agree.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
And they're such expert maintenance men and plumbers and all that.
He's right.
No, he's not.
You're really good at unclogging sinks and toilets.
Yeah.
With your arm.
Right.
Right.
No, come on. That's getting old. Can't you think of something else that can unclog in your little joke?
Garbage disposal.
No, not the switch. I fixed the snowblower today.
No, that's true in real life, right?
Yeah.
Wookiees are so versatile.
Yeah.
Was
I can
like
do
that
too.
Slushy snow in there. I hate
and that. I'm not even like very engine inclined to fix engines. I'm pretty bad. You know, fixing like a little water heater is easy, but you know, unclogging a toilet is easy.
Yeah, that's really
fixing a two-stroke engine. Not so
easy.
Is that
what you did, or you actually just was part of the?
I don't know. Something was wrong with it. Something was wrong with it in the inside, and I just
rebooted.
I hit it, and it worked.
Oh, mine's a hybrid. I got a hybrid snow.
Oh, really?
Snowblower.
It charges as you go.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. The harder I push it, the more it charges.
I got a fuel cell one.
Oh, do you? Oh,
yeah.
Really?
I just have to put in some water and it goes.
Yeah, we're getting snow. It is snowy here.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm a little disappointed though because it's typical for our area to miss the big storms.
Yeah.
For some reason, there's something about our town. Like 15 miles away, they'll get like 2 feet of snow, and here we'll get like an inch.
Hmm.
I don't understand that. I blame the NGE.
Sony's fault, yeah.
Yeah. So, how am I? I'm good. I've been playing some EQ2 still.
You've been doing that a lot, yeah.
With Al McGill. Mm-hmm. And one of our other listeners from the past, Dak.
Oh, yeah? Really?
He's on there. He's in our little guild there.
Sweet.
So there's really only three people in our guild that actually play.
You're getting some cool loot?
I'm just playing it just for something different. Mm. I'm not, loot, whatever. It's just fun to do something different.
But is loot cool in that game?
Quests? I'm not even... Stop. I mean, it isn't even an issue with me. I'm not a big quester. The only reason I would question that game is because you kind of have to sometimes to get things.
Yeah, you didn't even like the movie Quest for Fire.
No, not at all. Exactly. I don't even like our phone company.
What? No, is it Sprint? What?
No, Quest.
I know.
Dummy.
Wookie.
Yeah, so we did that. I've been playing. I did some Star Wars Galaxies last night.
Yeah.
But I've been busy. I get in our forums every day. I'm in their forums. If I don't reply, I am there, and I'm reading and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And trying to keep a few people under control.
It goes all to your Windows mobile device.
I used to be able to read the form. I used to be able to read the official dev tracker form when there was an RSS feed for it.
Yeah, get that going.
I'm like, come on, please.
He wants it to his Windows Mobile 5 device.
Chapter 5 is alive.
Yeah, I know.
Chapter 5 is alive.
Johnny 5.
And, I logged in.
Stacey.
The wrong podcast.
Nice that,
our Short Circuit podcast is on like
software.
Tuesday nights. So, you get the wrong night.
You know, I never saw it, but go ahead.
Yeah, that's pretty bad.
I just had friends who always quoted it.
Who's not seen Short Circuit? I mean, come on.
Raise hands.
That's like the other day you told me you never saw The Goonies.
I hadn't either.
Can you never have seen The Goonies?
Here's how. I didn't see it. That's how I didn't see it.
Ugh.
Yeah, it's just I'm of the wrong age bracket, you know? Yeah.
Well.
When you were saying that, I was probably seeing Rambo. Number 5.
Yeah, Johnny 5. Chapter 5. Johnny Chapter 5.
And, chapter 5 is alive.
I would say it is about what I expected. I tried to not have expectations.
Right.
Because, just from the direction things have always been heading, it isn't the direction that I would have liked to have seen, but what I would like to see really doesn't matter.
That's exactly what I said when the marriage counselor before we got married, my first marriage.
Really?
I have no expectations. I'm hoping for the worst, so yeah.
Yeah.
So that's what it sounded like.
You right. Probably should have, figured that out, a little ahead of time. Instead
first
of,
marriage.
Yeah.
I need your help, son.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, you could have used your help, too.
Right. Should have asked him about marriage.
What do you think about marriage, Palpatine?
You must break through the fog of lies.
Yeah.
Oh.
Agreed. God, he speaks words of wisdom.
Yeah, most of them yours, but...
Can Sith be married?
I think they will.
All right. I apologize. Chapter 5 is alive.
Yeah. Third time we've said that now. Or at least the fourth or fifth.
That's not quite easy.
Yeah. Okay. That's, all right. You said it.
That's what my friend always said in college.
Yeah, your friend must have been a geek.
He was, totally.
I mean, not that we're not much better, but... So, chapter 5, what can you say? Oh, just...
Okay.
What? Get out of your system.
Nice software, Stacey.
All right, anything else?
Nope, that's it.
Are you sure? All right, thank you. Yeah, so chapter 5 is out, and you look like you're going to say it again.
I'm not.
God!
Good Lord, I'm not. I swear not.
All right.
Swear to Thomas Alva
Edison.
See,
now you got me all cautious and all worried. Chapter 5, what do you think? Just your overall, we'll talk about chapter 5 in details later, but overall, how do you feel?
Well, I'll tell you, on chapter 5.
How do you feel?
Now you're doing track 4.
How do you feel?
No, is that track 4?
4, yes.
Is that the whale one?
Yeah.
There'd be whales.
Okay, how do you feel about chapter 5?
I feel... Like, if it was like 100%, I've only delved into maybe 10% of it. Everything I like, because it's more stuff. I like more stuff.
Mm.
But I'm an entertainer, my tune, so it's more dances, more songs, more stuff to do, more buffs, blah, 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 blah.
Mm-hmm.
And more
and
stuff.
And the Xantha, you have a new instrument. Well, an
more
instrument
stuff.
That works now.
Right, yeah, so.
You know, I don't understand why the information about the new songs and new dance, I think it's just one new dance, is that all that is? One?
Two.
Two? Why wasn't that in the patch notes? I don't understand that.
I don't know. Maybe it's just to explore and they look really stupid, by the way. They're probably ones that just didn't make the cut before. I can't see them like making
new. That's possible,
game.
Yeah. You know?
They look stupid.
Because that would take motion capture
to
do.
Why don't they just make a new dance? I mean, I'm sure.
So they don't look good or what?
They're fun. They're just dorky. If you lined up all the dances and had, you know, like rated them 1 through 10, you know,
mm-hmm.
like PU or whatever that one, that your favorite one, that'd be like a 9 in your book.
Okay.
Yeah. Especially Flourish 5 on that.
Right.
That'd be like,
that
you'd
one
be like,
you love.
You'd be like, no, 9.5. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Right. But, mm-hmm. Like me, the breakdance too. I mean, those would be awesome. But these would be just like 2 or 3 out of 10.
These would be like the number 1 and number 2.
Yeah, they'd just be
at the bottom.
To me, that's my gut reaction. Because that's what people are saying. They're just like, try Jazzy too. It looks so stupid. You know, things like that.
Right.
Jazzy. It's called Jazzy.
I mean, I don't have a problem with reusing stuff that never was put in so as that we actually get something.
Right.
You know? I mean, something's better than nothing, and as long as that something works.
Yeah, right.
It has to work, at least.
Songs, good. I like songs.
Songs are good. The songs are kind of cute. There's a couple there. I mean, the two of them I like, and two of them are, not so much. But, yeah. You know, it's new.
Yeah, right.
It's new.
It's new stuff, yeah.
It is new stuff, and that's good.
Right.
And, so,
and
camps.
Droids. I got new droids. I mean, what's cooler than a new droid or two? I mean, that's cool.
Domestics, people can make the bioengineered components now again.
Oh.
Well, the additives, the food additives. They used to be bioengineered. So they can make foods better than they used to be.
Oh.
Because ever since the NGE, there was nobody to make these additives. There was no profession to make them. So you could not make food very useful.
Huh.
Food isn't as useful to me as it used to be.
No. It used to be mandatory.
It did lots of cool things, yeah. though. I mean, you took one kind of food, it made you go faster. It burst run. You took another one, it made you better at harvesting hides. You took another one, and it made you more resistant to bleeds. And now it's like, plus 25 agility.
Right.
Plus 25 stamina. Oh, those are fun. Those are
Johnny
lots of
Five.
Fun. Yeah. Oh, Stephanie, look, I have plus 25
now,
to
is
my...
Is Stephanie or Stacy?
Or whatever.
Okay, all right.
I thought it was Stephanie.
I get it mixed up.
Yeah. I think it's Stephanie, but I don't know. I'm not in the fan club like you. So, yeah, I mean, I'm glad that the stuff is in, so maybe at least food will be usable to the people in PvP that really, really, really care about those numbers
right.
a lot.
Right.
And that's good, that's fine, whatever. So
yeah.
I don't want to take away from something new that other people have. Munitions. I'm not sure if they got anything new other than the fact that their weapons can be crafted with sockets now for the upgrades.
Yeah.
But I don't think they got any new weapons or anything.
I know we're going to hit Chapter 5 later. Should we come back to just Chapter 5 stuff?
Yeah, okay.
I don't mean to take away from your segment.
No,
I mean,
no, that's all right.
Do you have like any macaroni and cheese recipes or something?
No,
or,
fine. It's fine.
Yeah. Come back, Yivvits. Don't go back.
No,
come back.
It's fine.
Come back. Treat. Wookiee treat. Right here.
What kind?
Your favorite. Liver snaps.
Ew. That'd be terrible.
Liver snaps.
Liver snaps. That's unlike Lando.
Lando.
They're liver snaps.
I was reading the forums. It made me remember that he's not in the game.
Why isn't Lando in the game?
There's no NPC. Or, I mean, there's no character Lando.
That's just weird. The traders are like modeled after him with their little blue cape or little blue shirt and everything.
You know, people were saying also in the forum, it was a cute little forum, or in a cute little thread, they were saying, oh, he really wasn't a trader. He was like a gambler. And people were like, ah, no, he traded Han to the Empire.
Yeah.
Oh, boo. You thought that was funny earlier.
No, I did not. I must have been laughing because I was trying to get something else done.
Daisy.
Stephanie. I don't know.
I think it is Stephanie. See,
you
know, that's the funny thing is, like, we could totally Google this. But we're going to get some email from somebody. Just so you know, the person in the...
But that's okay.
That's true.
It's something for us to
go
play.
Ahead. Tell us this, Stephanie.
All right. And so, Mr. Bubble, that's what I've been doing. I've been playing a little EQ2. I got into Star Wars Galaxy. Last night, I did a little bit of rearranging in our guild hall.
Yeah.
I don't know if you know... Well, you know this, but Thunderheart did a galactic hotspots feature on Starhaven, the city where we live.
Yes.
And if you haven't looked at it in like a week or so, you might want to go again. Yeah, I think you updated a little bit of information to have some different contacts on it. And also talk about the two different fleets, space fleets that are in the town. Are there just two?
There's neutral.
Neutral.
It's,
okay,
it's
three,
a pilot
three.
Town. It was founded as a pilot town. Very fast.
Yep. Yeah, we were just after. I mean, we just moved there.
I was. Yeah, well, right.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, you moved there because you were piloting.
That's cool.
So, and then you're like,
cool.
I lived in the middle of nowhere because my entire town left. So,
yeah, Ben Kenobi lived in a place that made yours. Yeah,
I had nothing to do with the fact
like
that they
Trump
all left.
Plaza
by the way,
compared to yours,
I had nothing to do with why they all left.
Right.
that was a cool little feature.
That was nice, yes.
And there are a couple screenshots on there of our really cool studio that Xerthas, one of our listeners, made. Yes. And then there was one that was like of the upstairs. And I feel bad because it was totally not. I mean, the upstairs is all torn apart.
It really was just torn apart.
So right. I went in last night and I started to clean it up a little bit, make it look a little nicer.
Cool.
So you can do that. You can go there and visit it again.
Good.
And again.
Check it out.
So enough about me, but Mr. Bubble.
Yeah, now let's get to the important stuff.
Let's get to you, Mr. Bubble.
Yeah, enough about you. What? Yeah, I'm Mr. Bubble. How are you?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
It's Grievous. Grievous, how are you?
Yes, what's the situation?
Well, I'm about to tell you about Mr. Bubble here. Are you ready?
Oh, gosh, poor guy.
I know. I was at the clinic.
Go sit in there, okay?
No, I was in the room. I was at the clinic the other day, just getting my regular checkup. And he was there, and he had like the biggest oxygen tank with him. I feel bad for the guy, really.
Yeah, because so bad.
Yeah, I know.
So, oh, poor guy.
I like. He's a nice guy. He's fun. You know, when you're in the waiting room at the doctor, there's people that you don't talk to, and he's awesome.
Right.
I didn't even read like the crappy old Time magazine from 5 months ago.
Or the Highlights magazine.
Highlights for kids. Yeah. Or Ranger Rick. I'm done with those. Read them. No, I just talked with Grievous about the old good old days. Hey, good, big laugh. Grievous is great.
Yeah. Tell us about your week.
I'm Mr. Bubble.
Okay. What would you go on
Ladies,
with it?
How are you? How are you doing? I'm a solist, and that's the biggest thing when I explain this to people outside of the game, which, you know, I just go up to random people. It's like, I do a podcast. You know, no.
What?
Yeah, a podcast.
What do you mean?
It's like an internet radio show.
I don't believe that.
Yeah, well, when I tell people about this game, trying to explain this crazy game, always when I mention you, Wookiee, people are like, oh, right. Wookiee, of course.
Chewbacca!
Tarful, of course.
Oh, yeah.
No, Chewbacca, right away. But then I say, well, first of all, maybe they haven't even seen Return of the Jedi, because you know, if I talk to the older crowd, maybe they've seen A New Hope, which they refer to as Star Wars, noobs. If they have seen Jedi, I'll say, you got to remember the Lando Calrissian and his pilot on the second Death Star attack run. That's me.
That kind of guy.
Sullustan from Sullustan.
Spits everywhere.
All right. I don't have that shield. Whatever. Blah, 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 blah. But that's me.
You know, I just realized?
What?
When I do that, I'm actually doing it as Lando.
You're right.
He doesn't sound anything like
Let's
that.
Let's hear that again.
Blah, 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 blah. That's like Lando. I'm wrong on that.
Well, how would it be? How should it be? You're so right. I want to wave file that for my phone.
Oh, you should have
a ringtone of you going.
Sorry to interrupt you there, but go ahead.
Doesn't he use something like that once? Right, exactly. That's when Lando's telling a horrible joke.
Okay, you've made it clear. You're a soloist. We know what you are. We know who you are.
In real life, I'm in the retail biz. I play this at night once in a while, but sometimes I just don't play it a lot. It's a time-consuming game. It can be.
Star Wars?
It sucks you in, yeah. I like to talk to everybody in there, so sometimes I just...
You're a social butterfly.
In the game,
you're a social chameleon butterfly.
Not as much.
Oh, come on. You're chatting up with people all the time in real life.
Yeah.
You just find strangers on the street and talk about typewriters with them.
Yeah. Whatever.
Whatever. I'll tell that story sometime. Oh, go ahead, though.
That'd be an exciting story about a typewriter.
I think it would be.
Oh, I agree.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, he wants to hear about my typewriters.
He's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nothing. Oh. You know, you got to admit, though, the Selectric did change the typewriter world. 1961. You got to admit that.
We'll talk about your typewriter later.
You can go play with your friends later, Luke, or whatever.
You can waste time with your friends later.
What are we getting here at?
This is Mr. Bubble. This is
what's happening.
This is the Mr. Bubble part.
I've tried everything in the game that's really interested me. Like I've tried combat, not too interesting.
Right.
I've tried crafting, interesting for a long time. After a while, meh. Because I just didn't like the handling of the
counting.
Numbers
are
forward. Because I had, as I said, there are weeks that I wouldn't play, and I get back on and have all that email on auction items expired.
And then your vendors went away and
right.
You lost everything.
So I wanted to set
You're
up
like,
a,
oh, noes!
But I love space. I love Princess Amidala in space. No.
Do you think they suspect that they're talking space?
No, I do not.
But space is awesome in Star Wars. It is so good in Star Wars Galaxy. It is so fun.
Right. Probably the only expansion that really came across as ready ready to be published and polished.
And a bona fide expansion. I mean, that's an example of expansion.
I don't mean that as any disrespect to anybody that worked on the
indie. Don't you be disrespectful.
No, but seriously, I mean, I don't want to make it like, oh, the other ones were crap.
Right.
You know, I mean, but you have to admit, the Gem to Lightspeed was really, really good. I mean,
that's what an expansion should be. I mean, just unlock stuff in the game that you had no way of doing before.
Right.
You know, not just like a twist on the same kind of hunt and quest and loot stuff. But it's like when you put Jump to Lightspeed in there, all of a sudden you can fly around in a ship and just kill other. And, oh, man.
Now, what would be really nice, though, is if eventually, someday, that because they really treat them as two different games.
Right.
And I know that they give that as an excuse a lot. And I use the word excuse kind of loosely there. But they give that as a reason for why this won't work or this won't work. And to me, I look at it as a player and go, hey, this is Star Wars. I shouldn't worry about space and ground shouldn't be.
Right. They're always going.
Shouldn't be separate.
Right.
You can't take your bounty hunting into space from the ground. I mean, how is that at all like the movies?
That's an excellent point, isn't it?
I mean, Boba Fett didn't go. Oh no, he went
Boba
space.
Fett, where? Boba Fett?
No, he took off already. I can't track him now.
Yeah.
Long gone, sir. I can't do anything about
that. What? He left the planet? Oh.
Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. Can't catch him.
Great point.
I didn't mean to take it over. But space is cool.
I've always focused on space. I that's really enjoyable. And now, the entertaining stuff is just so fun. It's just there's so many things you can do, and it's just like you don't have to do squat. If I'm gone for a week or two, it's okay. I just come back and it's like, oh, Mr. Bubble, you know, rather than like, all your auction items have expired.
Exactly.
Your backpack containing.
You told me you'd have a droid ready for me.
Oh yeah, right.
Where's my droid brain?
Yeah, right. So yeah. I'm at a comfortable spot right now where I can, if comfy. I want to, I can go fly my ship around, my little TIE fighter. I'm an Imperial to the core. Because as a kid, Imperials were always the coolest. I don't know why. It was too easy to like the Rebels.
Because you're dark and sinister.
Well, that too. But it was so easy to like the Rebels. But my friends and I, most of us liked Imperials.
Yeah.
They were mysterious, and you just didn't know much about them.
You know what's strange is that those other friends, a lot of them are in jail now.
Yeah,
what happened?
Why? Stillwater State Prison. I don't know why.
That's weird. They all are really in big Imperials, and now they're... I know. Anyway.
Now they're dealing meth. I go figure. I don't know what that means.
I don't know either.
No, but it was always a mystery of the Empire, because back then, they never showed the Stormtrooper with their helmet on. I mean, just things like that were just mysterious.
Yes, that's true.
Right.
Yeah. So, are they human? Are they... what are they?
All right.
Yeah. Are they Solists? No. They'd be too short.
Are they Amperu? No.
Oh, that'd be kind of hot, though. In a weird way.
Yeah. She's a hottie. Yeah, no question.
Perfect
spot.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's what you
blah,
like.
Blah, blah,
blah. Yeah. Blah, blah, blah.
You know what?
Blah, blah, blah.
All right, You know what I wish they would improve in-game are dice.
Dice. You and I talked about this last night.
Dice and chance cube.
Ah, the Jeffy Chance Cube here. Yeah. Let me roll and see if we'll get development time. I think you're not.
Here's my beef. And me, I'm just hoping. I'm using our pulpit to see if anybody can help us.
Our pulpit is open.
Because I was working on some dice games with friends. And I think I got one. That's going to be fun. But here's the stopper. It's in the dice game, you got to rapidly roll again and again.
Again and again.
Only way I can figure out to do it now is to the inventory item, do the radial on it.
Yeah.
Because you can't do the radial from a toolbar, I don't think.
No.
It's just like, remove it.
Yeah.
And then pick how many dice do you want to roll and that kind of thing.
Right.
It's just a pain in the butt. So
slash command is what they need to do.
Awesome, yeah.
Can we get a slash command that just says roll? I mean, I even looked to see if I could figure out a way to, if there was a slash command, and not as like a hack. I mean, just saying there are a lot of commands that a lot of people don't know about that valid and not bugged. They're just people don't use them.
Like you can bank tip yourself $10 million.
You could do that.
Just like with a proper
you can
code.
Pay your harvesters through a slash command.
Right.
But it'd be really cool to have a slash command for the dice. I mean, that seems I know it's such a simple or stupid thing, and in the long run, you know, I'm sure they'd go, well, do you want content or do you want dice? You know, why do we have to pick all the time?
But just because I'm in the canteen a lot, just standing around, and there are some. I used to play some dice games as a kid and with my folks and that. We're in the Midwest here. We do stupid things. But there were some really fun ones that we've had a lot of fun with in real life. And I just, one of my, I figured out really did work. I tried it with somebody and it really worked good, except for the dang part of rolling the dice.
Yeah, because you got to go into the, oh, hold on. I got to go to my radio menu.
Right.
Don't take this wrong. Radio menus, I like radio menus. Cool. I hated that they were really marginalized with the NGE. Right. That was really a big, bad thing, in my opinion. But in this instance, if you really want to use the object to do a social kind of game,
yeah,
that seems like a really small change to make that you could open up a lot of social aspects.
Or a nice, I guess this just popped in my head. I mean, just a nice thing would be if they had, maybe they don't have a single dice object. I don't think they do.
I think they're
just, the only ones I've seen are kits. If they had a single dice, you could put on a toolbar and just click on it and
roll.
Yeah,
or click it on a toolbar. That would
perfect.
Work too.
That'd be perfect. Yeah.
Or just click it once in your inventory.
Right.
That would work.
That'd work too. I don't know.
That'd work too.
I believe it's true. I believe in God.
I believe it. Yeah.
Right, yeah, that's my latest crusade. That's a good crusade. That'd be fun.
Well, that's something I left off of my list on accidentally last week about content.
Yeah.
And that's another thing is the social aspect is big. And I know it's hard to grasp for, you know, whoever's in charge sometimes that Star Wars would be a social thing.
Yeah,
people like, why would you want to log in and like go and talk and stuff?
Yeah, really.
But that's just what the game kind of did a little bit, you know?
Yeah.
So why not try to reinforce that a little bit and add some of that stuff, like the casino stuff in games.
The Lug Jack
and the Jubilee.
Yes.
I mean, they really don't mean much.
No.
I mean, it'd be cool if there was some, I don't know.
It's gimmicky. I mean,
it's a gimmick to do something for a while.
It's just not,
and if they could be placed in player cantinas.
Oh, God.
Also, I'd like to see other cantina styles that are in the game or other building styles that could be used as a cantina.
That'd be good.
I don't know. I got more comments on that stuff later. But.
Yeah. Okay, so latest crusade, dice. Let's make dice easy.
His crusade is dice.
That's about it.
But
you're right. The cantina social part is getting more wealth than you can imagine. It's pretty important because it's something that...
It builds community.
Well, it's something you can't program. You got to program the tools so it makes it easier for people to socialize and do things like that.
That's right.
And with those tools... Then we suddenly get a cantina pack with 20 actual human beings. Human beings, the most creative soul out there.
You know what's funny, too?
And people, these people on their quest, they come in there and all of a sudden they're like, oh my God, these are real people here. How fun.
When we started to have those little parties that we have once in a while, in the very beginning there, it was a time when there weren't a lot of, it was a pretty down time in the game.
Oh, that's why we started, absolutely.
And,
right.
And there were other people doing parties and they were getting visits and stuff. It's not like we were just some... Oh my God, parties? Who would have thought of that? You know? But we just said, hey, let's just do this and let's try to get people to come. And and sometimes there are not a lot of people there and sometimes there are more people.
I remember just going to Starports and people I didn't know. I was like, please come to a party.
Yeah, exactly.
Or you,
but,
come on.
But it's funny how many, you know, people that you that were just walking through there for a quest, a combat thing, would show up and then be like, what's this? And you tell them, oh, this is a party. They go, how can you dance? And you tell them how to dance, and then they really enjoyed it. So there is more to it than
comments like, well, I've just never seen more than three people in one room at the same time. Do you remember that kind of stuff?
Oh, yeah.
That was so sad, you know? That was such a down part. In fact, I got some...
It's still not perfect.
I remember, because we did it probably in one of the absolute low parts of the game for us.
It was
like a month or two after NGE.
Yeah,
we were talking about quitting. You know, blah blah blah. Everybody you knew is quitting or talking about quitting. And I just remember at one of our parties, like second or third one, some elders had logged in, and elder entertainers. You know, from the good old days. And I just remember getting like three questions. They just said like, "Who's running this party?" And I said, "Oh, Yivvits and I put them on." Actually, what I said is like, "Me." I said no, but anyway, and they said, "Well, what's the deal?" And I said, "Well, we just wanted to do something Sunday night,
social,
right?" And they said, huh. And then I got like a bank tip for like 10 million bucks.
Hey,
10
wait.
Million credits.
I don't remember.
I tipped you 1 million. No.
I don't remember getting any money.
Dude, I split it. Whatever I get, I split. You know that. I split 90-10. Yeah, but it was just, that's how they were just like, huh, 10 million credits. Bam. Because they're just like, I can't believe people are doing this anymore.
Yeah. And there's been a few parties where we get some people there that just don't get it.
Right.
And they're really, really rude. I've noticed, though, lately... We have not had a big problem with that as much.
Oh, yeah. Good point.
And I think people, you know, we've even had some of those people come back and actually enjoy the thing, you know, and actually dancing or, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
Or not being complete asshats.
Right.
And I think that speaks for the power of just, you know, trying to be nice to people and not just owning.
Very Minnesota. Yeah. Very Minnesota.
Very
secular.
Well. Now, talk
Killer
about the
told
news
a horrible
and
joke.
He tells terrible jokes.
No.
All the time.
But, like, naughty jokes.
Yes, I know. They have a joke show.
Oh, my God.
They have a joke show a couple times a year, and it's dirty.
Oh, my God.
It's great.
Yeah, well, actually, it's a really funny joke.
It's great.
I've been telling a lot of people. But anyway.
It's great.
So that's a blast, and we are back. We had one last Sunday. We're trying
one
to
this
a,
week.
Huh? What?
We're having this week, right?
Yeah, definitely.
They won't get the show in time, but yeah.
No.
This week.
By the time you listen to this,
we'll have had it.
Yeah, we will have
it. And I'm going to start putting those party announcements in our RSS feed. Perfect. So if you've subscribed to that.
Indeed. Mmm, yummy. Good food. Good feed.
Yeah, so you'll get announcements there. And then we also have like a guild in the game. You can come join that too. Yeah. I mean, you're not going to probably find a bunch of people there all the time, but you know.
It's some.
There you go. You can log in and have fun.
Okay, so that party announcement will go in the feed, huh?
Sure, why not?
That's a great idea.
Why not?
How does that appear to some? So if you subscribe, like we said earlier, in
I don't know how it shows up in iTunes. We'll have to find out.
But
in an RSS feed, it would show up.
It goes right to your Windows Mobile 5 device.
Well, yeah, or whatever you've got. Yeah.
Your aggregator.
Or if you get Sidekick.
Sidekick 3.
Sidekick 3. Bling. I love it.
Shut up.
Should we play some voicemails?
Yes.
You want to, how do they get more of our show?
They can go to www.swgpodcast.com. Or I guess swigpodcast.com, as they say out.
Yeah, but that could confuse people because swig sounds like it's got an I in it.
Right.
This is more like swish.
Or www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com.
Or you can call our voicemail and leave a message. 651-314-4357.
Well, let's hear some.
Okay.
It's really my favorite part of the show. Almost.
You love it.
Except for the end. The end is my favorite part, but this is my second favorite part.
Hey, Yivvits MrBubble. Hey. This is a Krekos from the Shadowfire server. Krekos? I just wanted to say, good podcast. I've only heard two episodes. And, like, if you had a chance, would you PvP and base bust? And that's it. Thanks. Bye.
Thanks for listening and calling.
Base bust.
Is he talking about the thing where you go and, like, I don't know, now put a base down?
That's
and then,
hopefully been fixed, I believe.
Yeah, they added some timers.
Like a four-hour
timer. They added some timers now. So, you know, I'm never driven by the whole Galactic War thing because I have other issues, like, with targeting, which if you're new to our show, I go on about targeting all the time. And shaders. I got a new shader one.
Yeah, you do. That'd be great. I can't wait for that.
Oh, I'm sure you can't
wait.
So I
got to go do some work.
Your eyes look a little droopy already. Your eyes are a little droopy already. Right. So I can tell that's coming.
Right, right. Talk about shaders.
I'm not going to. Yeah. So would we do that? No. I mean, I'm not into PvP. No, so, and the PvE. And any combat right now, actually, I just don't like because it just doesn't.
It sounds like a bad exploit. I mean, I would never.
I wouldn't do it. So that's
pulling more than one droid at one time. Yeah, I do that because that's
for a party. I mean, come on,
exactly.
You should be able to have more than one droid. I'm just saying.
Exploit. Right, it was meant to be, but anyway.
Yeah. So thanks for calling though.
Excellent.
Hey, give it to MrBubble. Yes. This is a bottleneck from the Shadowfire server. I'm a tailor. Have you ever played them? Because they're like really fun. Because you get to make clothing in Chapter 5 out in the test center. Would you like respect to them out of entertainer?
Would you respect?
To a tailor?
Yeah.
No. Probably not.
I mean, I probably wouldn't either. I mean, I guess I could. But being a Wookiee, there's only a few things I can wear. So I'd be a little limited to being able to try out my wares
right.
on myself. I'd be like, oh, okay, should I wear the dark brown Wookiee hood or the black Wookiee hood?
Yeah, ooh.
Okay, great. And that requires art, so we will never get anything new for Wookiees.
Right. They're too busy making icons or something. But Tailors
are... It takes a whole publish to do an icon.
If I want to make a whole bunch of different clothes for myself, because then you can make exactly what you want.
Yeah.
But it's fun to talk to other people and go... It's fun to go shopping.
I don't like that you can just respect between the professions. The crafting thing.
Progressive.
Well, yeah, of course it does. But I just... I never liked the respect anyway, so...
Okay.
Different story.
You get no respect. Oh. This is a caller, dude?
Hello?
Hello? Oh. I don't know who that was.
It actually was on our voicemail, for sure. It was like cross circuit or whatever.
Oops.
Short circuit. It was a short circuit.
It must have been.
Hello, this is Aaron, formerly of the Gorath Galaxy.
Hi, Aaron.
And I'm about to play that great little party game that everybody knows. What would you do if you were Sony and LucasArts? aside from depression therapy and all that. My thinking is that the game needs an infusion of cash, and there's no reason for Sony and LucasArts to dump an infusion of cash into the game. There aren't enough players to support massive upgrades and overhauls. Here's what I'm thinking. There's a TV show coming out in 2008, the live-action show that is set between episodes 3 and 4. And, of course, Star Wars Galaxies is set during episode 4. If I were Sony and LucasArts, I would be racking my brains trying to come up with a way to convince the player base that role-playing be damned. What we need to do is roll back the timeline and set Star Wars Galaxies at the time of the TV show. There are going to be Jedi running around on the run from Order 66, so there's an actual in-game rationale for there being plenty of playable Jedi, and with the cross-promotion and marketing opportunities there, that would be the excuse or the opportunity that would be needed to free up some extra marketing money to come in. They wouldn't just have to try to keep the game running based on the revenue that they're getting from a dwindling subscriber base. There'd be extra Star Wars TV tie-in money to come in, and that could potentially spark some innovative development, some new things to do. Will they do it? I don't know. Take care.
Excellent call. Excellent call.
Well, here's my thing.
What's your thing?
My gut feeling is that the reason that the last two expansions just didn't seem completed in time, and there's still bugs in all of them, and the reason we have the NGE is because of marketing money and not because of that they wanted to, make the game better. I mean, they want to make more money. I mean, and who wouldn't? I mean, I guess if you're running a business, right?
Right.
You want to make more money off of it.
Yeah.
So I guess I would be a little hesitant. If I was hesitant, I'd be hesitant to have it an expansion or a change that was marketing driven because of the track record so far.
That's an interesting, yeah.
You know, then you're throwing out, if you're going to say, role playing be damned, does that mean you're not going to support it or what?
I think it's very unlikely that they do that, but. You mean the TV show? I mean, it doesn't. Okay, the success of the TV show does not preclude those people from still playing the game, because they could easily add some objects from the TV show into the game, so it's in our timeline, just like they do with the old.
Crap. Well, they've already done. Yeah, I mean,
exactly. That's what I mean. But the things we haven't seen yet in the TV show, they could just add some content from that in the show.
We're supposed to be in the episode 4 timeline, and the two new droids we got.
Yay!
I shouldn't complain because we got two new droids.
By the way, I love my droids. They wouldn't have to add much so they could make everybody happy. Because I think if you get the people excited about the TV show, they're going to say, wow, an online Star Wars game, I'll play.
They should have added female protocol droids.
God, I wish they would.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, excellent call.
Yeah. Like I said, if I was going to get an infusion of cash for something like that, I would want it born out of actually wanting to make the product better and not just to market it.
Right.
Because marketing, you can do to death. You just can't run an MMO like you run a promotion at McDonald's.
Right.
You know? Or your latest McDonald's. Action figure.
I almost went to McDonald's today. Now you had to make
it. Can't stand McDonald's.
Why? Yeah.
Just nasty.
You've always felt that way or what?
Well, I mean, if I got to pick between that and, say, Subway or something.
Well, I didn't ask you that.
What does that hurt
like
your
saying,
feelings?
No, it's just like
you,
saying,
you make it sound like I said somebody just died or something.
It's like saying, I don't like Coca-Cola.
What do you mean?
It's like, well,
what do you,
yeah, okay, whatever.
I always thought you loved McDonald's.
I don't like General Motors. Yeah. Okay. That was Yivvits, Brian.
Okay. Hey, Yivvits and Mr. Bubble. This is Greg with the Narrative Galaxy. Just calling to say congratulations on making the launch pad. I was pretty excited to see that. I listened to your podcast yesterday, and where you interviewed people from SOE, and enjoyed that podcast greatly. And then was very pleased to see you guys made the launch pad. So congratulations on that.
Thanks.
Yeah, Greg.
That was cool.
We met you, Greg.
We did meet Greg at one of our meetups.
That's
one of the most things we keep saying we got to do.
This one we for sure are.
This one we got to do, though, because we got people that might be visiting.
Yeah, we definitely have a general on his way to visit.
Perhaps. General.
Yeah. The shuttle's going to land, and there'll be the puff of smoke, and you'll see his feet. The camera will pan up, and it's like, Canaryville! I'm a rebel! Named after a bird!
Another happy landing.
Yeah!
My name is Jack Bauer. Who am I talking to? Who is this?
What? This is Yivvits and MrBubble. Anyway. I don't know what that is.
Okay, great. Now we got that over with. We had a discussion as to whether or not we're going to actually use that. Like a 20-minute discussion.
That's right.
Or more.
I won.
Yeah, you did. One more time, she shut up.
My name is Jack Bauer. Who am I talking to? Who is this?
Okay.
Great. So there's your plug.
I don't have time to tell you. I'll tell you in the car. Yeah, he's always doing that. It's like he's got these huge things going on.
He's got a lot going on, yeah.
I know.
Saves the world all the time.
I know, and they're asking, like, what is he doing? It's like, this person.
Is my mother here?
Yeah. No. I have to tell you something about your mother, Anakin.
What?
She's like a mummy kind of wrapped in a shroud here.
I don't believe that. Obi-Wan's been here, hasn't he?
Well, you know, he says that when he picks up Obi-Wan's card, his business card. Business card.
Obi-Wan's been here, hasn't he?
Yeah, exactly. His business card is on the counter. He's looking at, we should make Star Wars business cards. Another idea of I'll
we
never
have
do.
Business cards. What are you talking
no,
about?
Star Wars ones. Like
oh, Star Wars
Obi-Wan
ones.
Kenobi.
Oh, right. Mr. Bubble.
No. It would say, oh, it'd be like the character of Obi-Wan.
Oh, okay, I gotcha.
It'd be like his business card.
Jedi. his profession. Jedi.
Exactly. Owen Lars, farmer.
Moisture farmer.
Moisture farmer. Picture of evaporator as the icon. Lars Farming Inc. or something.
Lars Farms.
And to top it off, you'd want to put those like in public on those little cork boards where you can put up your
card.
Oh,
yeah.
Or throw them in the Subway business card free lunch thing.
Yeah.
They're trying to call
Owen Lars. You can reach me on Tatooine. Comlink number A77A2B.
Talos Wireless.
FF78.
F.
There's our callers.
Cool.
So thanks for calling, people.
And Jack Bauer called. How cool is that? All right.
Yeah, that's great, isn't it?
Yeah, you love that.
All right.
If you want to do that, you should.
We just did those.
I know, but they're just so they can do it. Right now, they saw how cool it is. They want to do it.
Oh, no, my friend.
What did you say? What did Dooku say?
Oh, no, my friend.
Oh, are you okay, Dooku?
Oh, no, my friend.
I guess not. 651-314-4357.
Yep.
Now, brand new, really impromptu, quick bit, really quick bit.
Quick bits.
Now, we used to do like...
It's quick bits with Mr. Bubble and Yivvits.
We used to do an impromptu character study, like on Inside the Actor's Studio or something. Yeah. No, this is a really quick one. I asked you as we were doing our prep here, I said, Yivvits, pick a character, creature, droid, or location. All right? And what do you say?
I was like, are we playing 20 questions?
Right. Just pick one.
Person, place, or thing?
No.
Character,
creature.
A droid.
And you pick droid. So then I researched a droid that... It had to be within the movies, and it had to be one you may not have heard of.
Yeah,
and just something like that. Just see how. And luckily, I bumped into one right away.
You're lucky. I mean, because honestly, I was worried that you might.
Yeah. Now here's the droid.
Okay.
Tell me about K-3PO, not C-3PO, but K-3PO.
K-3PO.
Who was K-3PO?
Who was K-3PO?
You tell me.
I'd like to know.
Well, who could it be? What do you think? What are your choices?
I think he was in Episode 3.
Okay. Episode 3 of the Jedi one.
I'm just going by where I saw protocol type droids.
Okay.
And he was in the landing scene when they came back and with the female protocol droids there. It's just sick. Okay.
Okay, that's your
another
answer.
Happy landing.
Oops, wrong one. Go ahead.
That's what Obi-Wan says when he hops into bed. Yeah. Like, no, he's nothing naughty. He's just like when he bounces on the bed and stuff.
Another happy landing.
Another happy landing.
Yeah. He's home from work and he hops into bed.
Hello there.
He says that too.
Another happy landing.
Okay, K-3PO. No, okay, so that your answer is Episode 3.
Episode 3, yeah.
Okay. No, another choice would have been Episode 4. Remember the very beginning? Oh, well, they shut down the main reactors. There's that other protocol droid.
Was
briefly.
That him?
No.
Oh.
But that'd be another choice, right?
Yeah.
No, that was Episode 4. Episode 5. Can you think of protocol droids in Episode 5 that are not C-3PO?
Ichuta?
Okay. Oh, no, it's Episode 6. Noob.
Are you... What?
Ichuta was... Ichuta! I'm a noob. Episode... That's...
They're in Bespin.
Episode 5. Yeah. No, it is the white one on Hoth. He's the white protocol droid branded with a command insignia. He is one of several droids stationed at Echo Base's command center. And it shows a picture of him in front of that radar thing.
Yeah.
You totally can picture him. Like frosty color white. And here's the sad thing on the one paragraph thing. The droid was smashed apart during the Imperial invasion.
Oh. That's too bad.
Poor K-3PO.
Oh.
But there's K-3PO. Now you know K-3PO.
Sad for him.
Isn't that cute?
/ comfort.
Oh. reassure. He cloned somewhere else.
He did, didn't he? Yeah. Sure. He had no cloning sickness.
Chewbacca either. Put him together backwards, too. Oh, you put me on backwards.
You overweighted.
Yeah, you put my legs on my head.
K3PO, that sounds more like a radio station.
Do it. Do it, K3PO.
K3PO. Now for weather with right. Jenny Johnson.
It's radio for droids. Hi. Jenny Johnson. It totally sounds like, man, you're bad.
Yeah, that was good. K3PO, don't forget him.
K3PO, no,
poor. Never forget
next
K3PO.
That's my bumper sticker.
Yeah.
And next time you see the movie, just you'll be able to look at K3PO. I clicked on the Expanded Universe tab. There's probably, oh my God.
Probably not much.
There's a ton of stuff.
See, well, oh it, you God. Know, it's so easy to make something up about him.
Yeah, that's true.
Because he doesn't even exist. We just made that up now.
He received some structural damage when he was swatted by a Tauntaun's tail. I swear to God. This damage was never repaired and was present on the droid when he was destroyed during the final Imperial invasion. There you go. Those dang Tauntauns.
I like the backstory creation for the most mundane thing.
I just picture, like...
It's like there's always a cause for something, you know? He could have just... maybe, like, he got in a tizzy with 3PO. C-3PO.
Right.
It's like, oh, no, you go! I'm not going to drive the princess's remote! Ugh!
Right. I mean, he could have just slipped on the ice, too. But no, yeah. It was like, oh, a Tauntaun had to be...
Tauntaun hit him, yeah.
I get to see those guys, like...
And it's later the Tauntaun that... Han rode.
Oh, right.
Because it's all connected.
Right, right.
Yeah.
It's the Tauntaun was slightly damaged, and that's the one that Luke's Tauntaun that died by the Wampa.
Oh.
And if that didn't happen, the Tauntaun would have died. Luke would have, you know, blah, 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 blah.
Right. Yeah, I think so.
Those, yeah, I picture like nerds who write that stuff. They got like some beanbag chairs and they order a pizza. And what are we going to talk about now? Let's talk about this droid. What do we call him?
We call
not
him
C3PO.
We call him K3PO.
No, what about J3PO?
No, K's better.
Okay, K3PO.
We use K.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, I agree.
Yeah. Thank you, Obi-Wan.
He's frosty like he's on Hoth. He's frosty white.
He's got to be camouflaged.
Right.
Pass the pizza over here. Okay, I have a rant now.
What?
Are you going to go to sleep?
Yeah. Can I? I gotta finish a project, man.
Okay, you wanna go log in and play for a little while?
Just page me when.
My beeper.
All right, go. No, ready, go.
I logged into a tune I rarely log into after chapter 5, and it's a human female. And I had
interested.
You. I had you log in one
interested.
Day. Interested? You logged in one day, and I said, make her look really old.
Oh, right.
So you gave her the wrinkly face.
Interesting.
And I noticed in the window, in the ID window, she had the wrinkly face. But when you made the change, you could hardly tell she was wrinkly. What are you drinking now?
Blue milk.
Blue milk doesn't have ice in it.
Oh, right.
Yeah, that's so professional. yeah.
Cool.
So, okay, so when we did this, and that was before Chapter 5, and she didn't just, it didn't seem that right. I'm like, oh, okay, it's Star Wars Galaxies. It doesn't work, whatever.
Right, right.
And so I log in this tune after Chapter 5.
What was her name?
Amorisita.
Oh, I thought it was like Helen or something.
No, that'd be a good name though. Helen. That's a great Star Wars Galaxy.
Is it now?
Helen.
Okay, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Helen. Gertrude.
Helen attacks for 550
old,
damage.
Old names.
Like, Ida.
Ida. Sophie. These are all my grandmas,
Sophie
actually.
Attacks. Ida Sophie attacks. I know, Ida is my grandma. Isn't that funny? Ida attacks for 550 damage.
Esther.
Esther attacks for 550 damage.
I'm sorry, Grandma.
Is that a relative?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, really? Is she passed on to the next plane of existence?
Yeah, a long time ago.
Yeah, so did Ida.
Gertrude.
They never got to experience the NGE. God bless him. That's good.
They were lucky. They were the lucky ones. They were the
few
of the lucky ones. No, so we logged out. I logged in chapter 5, and I'm in the bottom of my bunker, and I go to do some little crafting stuff.
Is that
on
code
her.
For anything, being in the bottom of the bunker?
No, it isn't.
All right.
I was going to do some crafting, and I thought something looked really weird, and I looked at the face of my little player, Toon.
Right.
And one half of her face looked all young and fine,
right.
And the other half was completely old and wrinkled. And I'm like what is going or? On here? Huh. So I start rotating her a little bit, and it has to do with one of the light sources in the room. It's like an ugly lamp.
Really?
It's an ugly lamp.
Yeah.
When it shines on her, it makes that part of her face, the wrinkly part that you're supposed to see.
Oh, my God.
And I took some screenshots, and it's in our forums. You can go look at it. And it shows, you know, one side, it shows the other, and then it shows, like, side by side.
Yeah.
Or split down the middle, almost. And you can rotate the two, and so you can tell where the light source is coming from. And I tried lots of things. I tried changing graphic settings, and then also, you know, logging out, logging in, all that kind of crap.
Right.
Didn't make any difference. And some people on our forums are saying that it's been like that for a long time, that some of the textures didn't always work right. And before, they weren't really textures. They were textures applied to the face, more or less. Now they're actually shaded, so they're, I think, that's a little different mechanic. Anyway, it sounds to me like that's been happening for a while. And it's unacceptable! You cannot put a bug in the game that affects a character's appearance?
Go, Yivvits! Come on, go!
Seriously, guys!
I love it! You're in fire, go! I love
it! But seriously, and right. I don't even care if it doesn't affect half the people, and I don't need a 20-minute discussion as to why it's hard to fix or anything like that. Yeah, you should not have a bug that appears to make somebody look like crap.
You should not have an ugly lamp.
If they want to look like crap,
right.
That's cool! But,
that's
I mean,
a good rant.
Seriously,
right.
I don't think that's acceptable. I think that is one of those bugs that, you know, for one reason or the other, it's been put off,
yeah.
Or because it's difficult or takes too much time. You know right. What? I don't care. I mean, you know, to me, if it takes too much time, that's not my problem. I didn't make the bug.
Right.
I don't want my tune to look like a freak.
Right.
And even though I don't play it. So I'm saying if there are people out there that are affected by it.
We're gathering at the courthouse at noon tomorrow.
Yeah, is it?
Austin, Texas. I'll see you there at the courthouse.
No, I mean, but seriously, I mean, I'm sure there's reasons. And it might not only be affecting people with certain drivers or certain whatever. Right. That's fine. But the fact is that other people have seen it, and it's not just me.
Right.
And that's where I always try to go with these things. And I'm not an idiot. I'm a computer person, so I'm not stupid. I go do my drivers. I
you
go
build
update
your
all
own
that
machines.
Shit. Yeah, we stop.
I'm kidding. I love that.
That's a pet peeve of ours.
I love that.
You know, I update all the drivers. I'm not stupid. So, and neither are a lot of the other players, too. Right, actually, right. None of the players are stupid.
Oh, my God.
Except you.
You kid. Oh, shut up. Star Wars Galaxy's players are like the brightest
of
any MMO. You've got to be kidding me.
Yeah.
This is not the crowd to, like, play talk down
I'm
to.
Right? But I'm sorry.
Not,
I mean,
not you, but, like, but, Sony. But,
like I said, if it affects the person's appearance, I would have quit by now if that was my tune.
Oh.
I mean, and you shouldn't have to not pick an appearance because of a lighting issue.
I had a girlfriend who looked horrible under a certain lamp.
I looked like you.
Oh!
No, but really, I mean,
yeah.
Textures on the ground, one thing. Tune textures on your actual persona of your tune,
right.
Not Ooh. Good at all.
Agreed.
Fix it.
That was a rant by Yivvits the Wookiee.
I'm serious.
That was a good rant.
You know, on top of that, you know, there's a lot of issues that they've got to fix and stuff. But, you know, if you start a fix for something and it doesn't work,
yeah.
I think, to me, it needs to be continued until it's fixed.
Finish what you begin.
You finish what you begin. And I know there's design and money things. And, you know, I sometimes worry that developers in general, I'm not pointing out anybody here or any you know, company. Because I think it happens to other, you know, like Microsoft even.
Yeah.
They forget that they
does
were
playing. Does it happen to Activision?
I don't know. I'm trying to be serious here.
Okay, me too.
Yeah, me too. I think that they forget that they were players once. Mm. And while they are still players, they have an insight that we don't have.
No, I believe you're absolutely right on that one.
It's like when somebody says, oh, look at those noobs over there, such idiots. I always say, don't forget, we were once all noobs. Don't forget that you were a player once. Don't forget what frustrated you. Just because you have the inside track is not an excuse.
And this is not to say they don't play games, because these guys are awesome
gamers.
Well,
no, I know that, but they have an insight.
But they go home and they don't play Star Wars as much as
otherwise.
Okay,
but they maybe do. But even if they do,
okay.
Thunderheart says he does, and I believe the guy, because he's Star Wars crazy man.
Thunderheart's great. I love
him. I mean, he's really into Star Wars.
He's awesome.
So I think he's...
We met him. That's so cool to meet him.
Yeah, but I do believe that they do play.
I
disagree with you on that a little bit. I think a lot of them probably do play it.
But I think they do it during their working hours.
But still, they have that insight that we don't. You have to look at it like you aren't a developer if you truly want to understand where we're coming from with some of our rants.
Oh, excellent point. But you're poor old lady. It's right down the middle. There's
Obi-Wan,
like,
what do you think?
He's right.
Thank you.
Obi-Wan, well done.
Oh, I agree. Another happy landing.
Whee!
Yeah, did you fill in Grievous on the situation here?
No.
Oh, what?
Do you want to fill in Grievous on
Me?
The bug situation?
Grievous, can you come in here, please? Okay, here he comes. Here, oh, God, he sounds so bad, doesn't he?
Poor guy.
What's the situation?
Well, Yivvits just did a rant on another bug.
Yeah, so. It was pretty good.
Yes.
Yeah, so... Okay.
Thanks. Can you leave again, please?
I gotta help him with... Hang on. I'm gonna help him with this oxygen tank. I just can't stand this. You just talk about something. I'm gonna help him with the tank on the way out.
What are you doing?
Okay. I had to help him carry his tank. It just drove me nuts seeing that guy carry the oxygen tank. That's all.
I didn't know what you were doing.
I know. I had to help him. It just bugged me.
Poor guy.
I know. He's such a valiant soldier before. Chapter 5 is alive. Ready? Go. Okay, now, this is interesting because you played a lot of Traitor, and I played a lot of Entertainer lately. And this one appeals to traitors and entertainers. That's the focus of Chapter 5.
I played a lot of Trainer. Traitor.
Yes. I mean, you're all about crafting. Yivvits crafting Wookiee.
Has-been. I'm a washed-up has-been.
Now, another thing is, in the olden days, like, by that I mean 6 months ago, for some of this magnitude, like, if we knew there was a chapter coming out or a publish that focused on traitors and entertainers, and we were both into that stuff, we would have, like, prepped and had a theme song and had just all this crap. Isn't it funny how little we even gave a crap about this one? Do you know what I'm saying?
I think it's because it's been too long in the making. I mean, I think it passed the point of being well done. It kind of turned out charbroiled. And I don't mean that in like the code quality or anything like that, but just emotionally. It's like you get to a point and you're like...
So I remember when we got the roadmap, was that a year ago?
Probably over a year ago.
Yeah, that there was a publish or chapter at that
which
time.
Which was pushed back a few times.
That's right. That was for traders. The big traitor revamp.
Yep.
Revamp. I believe I used the term revamp, right?
Yeah, revamp. And this is not really a revamp.
Yes,
I mean, they added stuff, but it's not a revamp, I don't think.
No.
Do you?
No. It's like, an old girlfriend, you know, ugly girlfriend, you know? She tried, what do you think? What, does this shirt look good on me? It's like, okay, the shirt's great. You're still ugly. You know,
so
that kind of thing.
Right. So
horrible analogy, but true.
Yeah.
That's the way this revamp looked.
Right.
So, yeah.
Right,
but,
I mean, it's at least it makes them useful in some degree.
Yes. It's more stuff.
There's more stuff.
It should have just been released as life goes on. It shouldn't be a big event. I mean, they should just...
Well, it's a publish.
But they should add new tunes and dances every now and then. They should add new stuff for traders now, new schematics here and there all the time.
Well, this is something that scares me to a little bit. And this is going jumping a little bit ahead, but in the forums, Blixdev, the new lead designer, who... Yes. So far, I kind of like him. He's a little edgy, but I think he's kind of being, you know, straightforward, and I don't think he's giving us any crap.
So he's kind of being nice, like, compared to the other developers. Is that what you're
saying? Well, I mean, they're all nice. I'm just saying he was commenting on a list of things that somebody wanted as content, and he asked the good question of what, you know, what do they think content is, and I think that that's a real issue right now, is what they interpret content to mean. And I posted my thoughts on it for whatever that's worth, about a penny, if that. One credit. Two credits, maybe, if I'm lucky. And the big thing that he brought up was that art resources are a big draw on them. And I'm trying to be careful here because I don't want to make it sound like I'm saying, just whining.
But all you can do, you can explain it from a player's perspective.
From a player's perspective, we've had the same three potted plants, or no, one potted plant for 4 years.
Yeah.
To craft, you know, there are other things in the, that was one of my comments is what, you know, there are things in the game as art already that may take work in the back end to make them usable as content, but that doesn't mean that they're not worthy of being done.
You know what they do if they act on it, they'll make like a holographic plant.
But I mean, there is art for a lot of objects. There's entire buildings. Now, that doesn't mean that they're all ready to be, you know, right up.
But someone did the artwork.
But somebody did the artwork. Mm-hmm. So leverage that.
Right.
But the other thing that scares me, too, is, you know, if what does it mean if we can't get a new set of armor? The wording he used was that a new set of armor would take up almost all their art
like
time.
For a month or something.
For a publish.
Yeah.
And, you know, I don't know what that means. It scares me a little bit. It scares me because... These are things that other games have been having for a long time now because they've been through all their, you know, building phase.
Right.
And now we're done with the building phase with as far as, you know, expertise. And now it's kind of like, okay, we did this. Now we can't really give you exactly what we should have been giving you the last 3 years.
Right.
Which is stuff to do and new stuff to look at. And that makes me a little sad to hear that. I mean, I'm glad he's being honest about it. But it makes me a little worried. I don't know what that means. I just don't know what it means, other than the fact that he was just telling it how it is. That doesn't mean we have to like it.
I mean, and there were big structural. I mean, the big things. I mean, entertainers can go. We've got our expertise, and we can go down this path or that path. And traders, same thing, right? They can go down.
Yeah.
I mean, that's big stuff.
Like I said, I'm not saying that the publish isn't good or that it wasn't needed or anything like that. And I mean, it does serve its purpose as far as to make them worthwhile to other players again. And you know, that's good. So I'm pleased with that. We got a little bit of stuff in here.
Yeah.
We've got the trader expertise. There's two trees, right? Production and specialization.
Okay.
And production lets you increase the size of your storage capacities.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. I mean, no. Okay. We kind of talked about it last time. It's like all the changes on there are like kind of.
Well, let me go through.
Yeah, they're good. It's good. Yeah,
and then also kind of decrease the costs and amount of resources needed to produce items. Specialization tree is gives you for your chosen profession. Gives you bonuses like, you know, you can add an extra socket for this high article of clothing, or you get plus X experimentation.
Right.
And that's what that one does. Entertainers, they have the artiste tree. Mr. Bubble, is it artiste? You can do your little hologram band with that one. Yeah. And you can increase the stats and durations of bonuses from the buffs that you can do now, the new buffs.
Right.
And then they have the drama tree.
Yeah.
And that is their combat stuff.
Then they have the Mr. Bubble Tree. No.
The Mr. Bubble Tree.
That's like
the bubble tree.
I know. Right.
And that's just, that gives them more combat.
Yeah.
And now both entertainers and traders have combat levels up to 90 as they go along. Traders don't have any specials or anything, but they can grab a combat level 90 weapon as long as it's not got a profession requirement. And then they can just pretty much auto attack or just attack the default attack, whatever it is. But the entertainers, they actually get some additional.
What does that mean? Could they take out like a level 80 mob pretty good?
It might be tough. I don't think they've got a heal or anything. 70? But I don't know. I don't know.
Okay.
I have not done it.
Gotcha.
So I don't know. They no longer have the no aggro status.
Yes. If you go down that path, there you go.
Right. No. You don't have it. There is not an option.
Oh, maybe I'm entertainers. I'm thinking entertainers.
No.
Are you sure?
They took that out.
I thought there was some that, I guess I'll have to.
No, that was the original thought.
Oh.
Old entertainer titles have been added back into the profession wheel. Master entertainers will be level 90. Hostile creatures and NPCs will no longer ignore entertainers.
Right.
That's just the way it is. They did not do the optional thing.
Okay.
So it doesn't matter. Either way, if you don't do the combat tree or whatever that is, that gives you better effectiveness.
Yep.
You'll still be a level 90,
of course.
And you can still attack, you know, do the default attack like traders. But the no aggro thing is gone.
Okay.
You don't believe me, do you?
I know. I just don't know.
No, I'm telling
you. I know. That's fine. I know. I read something like 2 days ago that was like, if you went down the drama tree,
you go down that path.
Go down the Mr. Bubble tree. I realize I'm not going to do much. What am I?
Well, come on. Exactly. What are you?
Who am I fooling?
You want to be an artiste anyway?
Shut up. I don't even care. I don't even care about the hollow dancers, but I want to be able to make the best buffs possible.
Hollow bubbles.
I do.
Hollow bubbles.
I mean, who wouldn't want three more Mr. Bubbles? I mean, I ask you. Tell me anybody.
One's enough. One's too many.
Right. Three more traders, Larrys.
New schematics are available for various trader professions throughout the expertise trees. And there again, they get the combat level 90, and the NPCs will no longer ignore them. Now, the new schematics thing, okay. There's new schematics for, like, camps, and camps are cool. Camps are very cool. That's new, and that's cool.
Right.
I like it.
Mm-hmm.
If you like. There are new schematics, so they get the camps. The weapons have been updated, so they have the sockets now.
Yeah.
I don't know if there's any new weapons. The new schematics that I know about for domestics are those bioadditives.
Right.
So you can make the foods better again. You purchase those schematics through your expertise. So you may or may not get them, depending on how you go.
Oh.
All right. Then let's see. We've also got the reverse engineering system for traders. And that is where you can take loot, and you stick it in a little device, and it pulls off little power bits and modifying bits, and you put them back together, and it makes a little thing. You stick in a weapon and gives you plus 25 agility.
Right.
Or plus 18 precision. But it makes it allow it so, you know, at least traders can get those items off there, and it maybe make people buy stuff. I still think we need decay, but that's just me. So there's two different types of the upgrades. There's permanent ones, and then there's the power-ups. So you can use one or the other. And different combinations give you different things.
Yep.
But there are features on that, in the forums, on the sites, actually. You should go look at that. There's one, and it tells you how to do it and that kind of stuff. I mean, that is big. I'm not.
It's very huge. I don't think we're going to know the significance for a month or two, because then we're going
to. I still go back to what it's modifying, though, is just silly. At 25 agility. I mean, come on. Do I care about that?
There were some buffs on the buff side of it. There were some buffs that are 150 for a lot of stuff.
Oh, okay, but still.
I got to figure out what those are.
Okay, well, we'll find out, I guess.
So some fellow entertainers made a lot of money selling them.
That's good.
We might have
entertainers should be making some money for
once.
We
might have lines again. That's what I'm excited about. There might be lines of people.
And then, but now we'll probably see the combat people. They're charging us for it.
Well, yeah.
I have to get one to play.
Exactly. So if it was so good back in those days.
And that's what got us messed up in the first place. So you just quit your whining.
Full circle. The circle will not be unbroken. Yeah. Right.
Too freaking bad you had to go visit an entertainer.
I know.
Served you well.
Then if we can plop a camp outside of Restus, hopefully, and charge a lot of money.
There, and you should.
Yeah, and if you That's don't have a goes. Buff, you're going to die.
Yeah, exactly. You didn't. I don't want to see an entertainer. Okay.
Why is a buff 200,000 credits?
Because it's Mr. Bubble.
Oh!
He's ripping you off. Camping is kind of cool. There's four, maybe more different types of camps.
Camping was cool in 2004, too, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was pretty cool, especially when Rangers, you had to have a Ranger to make
right,
one.
Right, right,
But now
right.
you have a Structure Trader. I kind of feel that Structure Traders, just by the nature of things, got the better deal.
Really?
Because they already had a craft, as far as starships, that was still usable.
Right.
And then they got the camps on top of it that people are going to want. Time will tell if the RE thing makes other ones usable again.
Yeah.
You know? We'll find out.
We won't know right
now. I don't understand why we couldn't at least get Potted Plant Style 2 as a schematic.
Yeah.
It's in the game. It's even labeled that way. Oh, jeez.
Poor guy. I actually got an instant message from Shipwright.
Okay.
Hubcap. And he just said he just used his new schematic. This is literally just came at 5 minutes ago. He said he just used the new schematics to make a cargo hold for his crate. It's 6K mass for the cargo hold, but it holds 5.4K of stuff.
Space stuff?
Yeah, of object. That's very nice. I mean, just things like that. I mean,
that is very nice.
And then, yeah.
Now, if it wasn't such a pain in the ass to harvest those.
Mark 6 and Mark 6 reactors and capacitors. And he said two new upgrades for engines. He says, I can craft nearly as good as RE now.
Oh.
Now, see, that's...
And that's significant.
Yes. And so, I've heard that from other people with the engines, that the L10, level 10 engines that are becoming obsolete, which is good. L10 for loot engines.
We will see what happens to the rest of the stuff, you know? I mean, maybe this will be the thing, you know?
That, it might be.
You know, that does the job. Gets the job done.
You're done.
Yeah, so the camps, though, there's different modules, and the different sized camps can have different numbers of modules.
Yeah.
And there are the following types. There's a cloning center, so you can clone there if you die. There's a junk dealer.
Very handy for you, you're dying.
A junk dealer? Hey.
No, yeah, help me on the junk dealer. That's so you can just go hunt and sell. And
I guess you just go and sell your junk, do it, whatever. Entertainment area, which I think is like a microphone and maybe some pillows or something to sit on for you. You like pillows? There's faction recruiters, crafting stations, and then shuttle beacon.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you can put that in, and it'll actually show up on the travel map as a destination.
That's so cool. Our parties, man.
So there you go. There's how we'll get to the parties.
We'll just tell the people hopefully, can you name the camp? What?
I don't know.
That'd be so awesome.
I don't. You know, I'm sure there would be some issues with people naming them dumb things.
Agreed. Well, it can throw through the name filter. Whatever.
Maybe it says your name like Yivvits' camp. Yivvits' camp.
You know how cool it'd be though if we can make it like Yivvits and Mr. Bubble party. You know, right. No, but normally, because in the shuttle, we'll say our party's on.
Oh, true.
On.
Yeah. Wherever.
Dallas.
Yeah.
You know, and then they look in the shuttle map and they're
on Tatooine.
There, you see Yivvits?
She can be reasoned with.
Right.
Now kill her.
Right. What?
What? Yeah, so that'll be cool to find the camps. We'll have to see how those work out.
Yeah,
I think it'll be good.
Attention.
Be good. Entertainers got their build-a-buff system, so you can build your buffs.
Yep.
So they've got that. And there again, there are some pretty good, and I think Thunderheart updated them just like yesterday with some new information, or some updated information, the Trader RE one and the build-a-buff one.
Cool.
So go and check in the forums and the announcements. I think it's listed there.
Yeah.
Or it's in the Star Wars Galaxies community page.
I think I'm gonna explore that. I'm gonna do my expertise there at first, just to figure that stuff out. Just to
check it out.
Make the most money.
Yeah, you got to be informed. Make the most money. maybe just like having people like pay you to not give them a buff would
that,
be
that too.
The most.
I might make a lot of money.
Be like,
just pay me to
just
shut up.
Don't know.
Mr. Bell, can you log off? How much if I thank
you?
You
just log off.
Just log off for 2 hours.
Please. That'd be nicer if he just did that.
How much?
How much?
I'll do it for 5 million credits.
So also for traders, a relist item has been added to the stock room.
Yeah.
And it will relist your item with the previous, or the it'll default to the item's last price and description. So when you were selling it last time, it'll just default back to that, so you don't have to remember it. That's good.
We talked to General Canaryville about, or I talked to General Canary. Who is General? Isn't that crazy?
I don't know. Just he talked to
crazy.
Canaryville.
Good for him. General, he's a general now. But he said that was
a
huge.
General.
That was huge for him. He's been a very dedicated crafter going.
Oh, unlike me, he has actually continued.
Yes,
and you know, I'll give him. There are people that craft, and I complain about it a lot. But
I mean, he
continued.
When I first started Space, like I started right when it came out, and like a week into it, someone I respected just recommended him, and he was
friend.
I went for you for the freebie cheap stuff,
right?
But when
you wanted the really
stuff,
good stuff, yeah,
right, Canaryville. No, but he had a little tent on Tatooine, and I believe it's still a little tent on Tatooine, but he just has very loyal crowd.
Just a little tent on Tatooine.
Good stuff.
That'd be a good song.
Yeah, right, it would.
Canaryville sells his wares.
Another WAV file for me. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. I had too bad I'm editing this week, so.
Oh.
Yeah, let's see. Oh, you can also relist multiple things at the same time from the vendor. Wookiee and Athorian vendors can now wear cybernetics. So I didn't know that was a big deal, but there you go. Now, if we could only wear lots of other things, too. Like,
Codpiece.
Wookiee Codpiece.
New schematic.
How many sockets does it have? Plus 25 agility. Plus 25 precision.
Endurance. Stamina. Oh, there we go. I hit the Yivvits laugh button. Laugh, Wookiee, laugh.
Stop it. That's
stamina.
Terrible. We're going to have to cut that. It's so dirty.
No.
Dirty.
Dirty. Dirty. From Minnesota.
Precision.
Right, right.
Okay, fine. I better.
Wookiee.
Foraging has been added back.
Yay!
Right now you can only forage for bait, and you have a 50% chance of getting bait and a 50% chance of nothing.
That's going to change the whole game.
Oh, yeah. But Blixtev chimed in last week and said, bing, bing, bing.
His little belly shakes like ring. Harry Potter.
Yeah. What?
Yeah, well, I don't know. Well, go ahead.
Okay.
Like, at the dining hall, didn't they, like, summon everybody with a bell or something?
I don't remember. I don't.
Whatever.
I don't think so.
Just humor me.
Okay, they did. It was a bell.
Yeah, well,
it was
a little bell. There
yeah,
you go.
Yeah, Professor Dumbledore was up there. a little bell.
That's what I mean, yeah.
Yep. So, he was saying that there's going to be more to foraging.
Annie, in my office.
But he didn't say anything.
Right.
Other than that. It's not going to just be for bait, apparently. Yeah, there you go. Maybe that's something cool to look forward to. Also, resources can now be stacked in stacks up to 1 million.
Yeah.
And I went and stacked up all my stuff. Mm-hmm. And it was great. I saved a lot of space. That's a good thing.
That is cool.
One bug I noticed with that, though, is you know how... You can go like in your data pad, right?
Right.
And they, you know how they took out that the change view button to change it to a list view? And then they put it back in because we complained?
Yes.
Well, in there, if you go to your data pad and you change it to a list view and you can click on the name, it sorts it by name, right?
Right.
You click the change view button again and they stay sorted by name, but as icons.
Okay. I'm with you.
You go to your factory in the input hopper and you bring up your thing of all your jumbled up mess in there. And you hit change view, list view, you sort it by type, because you want all the irons together and all this, hit it to change it back, it just stays how it was before. It doesn't keep that sort that you did. Well, that's a pain, though.
I got you.
When you're trying to find multiple resources, and you've got a, you know,
you're hopping between
them. You got like 50 in a thing, it's a pain in the butt. Fix it. That'd be good. There's more to Chapter 5. There's more. Would you like to know more?
Mm-hmm.
Go to their site. Go to the forums. If the forums are working, you can go there.
Fix the forum.
Poor forums.
Make them strong, Jordy.
You should never.
Make us strong.
I don't like it when functionality goes away.
Yeah, especially in 2007.
I mean, RSS feeds are old news.
Upgrades are great, but if an upgrade and you go backwards in time, it's like, what the heck?
It's like if Vista came out and it crashed all the time. Not just part of the time. You know?
It'd be like Windows 95.
Yeah. Or it didn't have a start button.
Right, right.
And you started it in DOS.
I would like
Okay, it's not that far
back.
Not
like you just queue edit again.
I mean, I know they're working on stuff, and I know it's on their list for RSS feeds because Garva has a thread going about, you know, a wish list. So
we had Garva. That's so cool.
Yeah, it was cool. And for all we know, they want it just as much as we do. So, whatever. It would be really nice, though. Yeah. Chapter 5. So go there and you can look it up, all the information. Did you have anything else about Chapter 5 you want to say?
Not really. I really look forward to it. I've only put a couple hours in on it. But I can tell you the buzz from the entertainers are, it's going to be kind of fun. I mean, I had a great pleasure playing with a new droid that was level 60. Is fun to do a new dance to that.
No match for Mr. Bubba's droid,
I think the buffs can fundamentally change some of this stuff. I mean, that's we don't know the ramifications yet of that. I mean, it might be horrible in balance. I mean, who knows?
Who knows?
Who knows?
Probably not. Everything's pretty strict now, with numbers. But we'll never know.
As podcasts go on, we'll know more.
The game is live and kind of has its own mind of when it does things. And so that's like with the resource thing, the resource spawn thing.
Is that true, Anakin?
Natural.
Is Anakin still with us?
Anakin?
What does he think about the game being alive?
What?
Yeah. Oh, wake up, Anakin.
I don't believe that.
No, he doesn't.
Were you asleep?
What do you mean?
Nah, he was asleep. He was so sleeping.
Obi-Wan's been here, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's so groggy. He found his card again.
He's like, Obi-Wan?
He found
Obi-Wan,
the business card.
Obi-Wan's jumping into bed.
Another happy landing.
Followed by what? When he finds somebody in bed.
Hello there.
Yeah, that's right.
Hi, Obi-Wan.
You need a sound between those two, like a female, like something like that. That'd be great.
Wait, okay.
Another happy landing.
Yep. Another perfect spot.
Hello there.
There you go.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Thank you. Thank you.
Looks pretty bad.
Looks pretty bad. Oh, jeez. Right. I think we should finish up. Go and read the notes. There's more notes in the forums. Go and try the stuff out. Don't take our word for it. As much as I have issues with stuff, you may not. And you probably won't. So log in and give it a try. Give it a whirl.
Have some laughs. Don't forget about the people. Play the game. You don't have to log in every day.
Just come to our party.
Every 3 weeks. Just
it's
together.
Okay if you want to play another game.
Of course.
Just don't make drama out of it.
Right. Right.
You know? I'm leaving. I'm leaving.
And here's why.
I'm back. I'm back. I'm back. I'm leaving. I'm back. Like that. Don't do that. That's silly.
I want that for my phone, too. Wave.
Yeah.
I'm waiting.
You'll never get that.
No?
No, you won't.
Another happy landing.
What else we got, Mr. Rubble? More of our show at www.swgpodcast.com or go to our forums at www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com.
Or 651-314-4357. Yivvits, I think we've done a lot. I feel good about this one. It was a meaty one.
It was beefy.
If Pee-wee ate this episode, he'd say, podcasty.
What would he say? Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits Mr. Bubbly.
That's right.
Right. All right, Pee-wee. Have a good week. Fine. Thanks a lot.
Hey, welcome to episode 72 of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble. Today is Saturday, February 21st, 2000. I was cracking myself up because when I said Mr. Bubble, I sounded like the no more. Shut up.